Welcome back, dear students, to the subject Computer Fundamentals. In the today's class, we will discuss about some of the important output devices. As we all know that computer processes the data and gives the result or the information. So whenever we want to keep this information or record in terms of a hard copy, or even if you want to retain this information for a longer period of time, we require to get the output, or we need to take the printout of it, or we need to take the hard copy, and we may want to send that information to some other organization or to any place when we want to transfer that information. So we need this output devices. So the most important output devices, the common output devices, are monitors and printers. So apart from that, we have plotters, screen image projectors, and we have this voice response system or our speakers. So all this comes under the category of output devices. So the basic task of these output devices is to transfer the information or the result to the user, so that the user can capture this information, or he can take the hard copy of this information, or in terms of when we talk about the printers or plotters, we can take the printout of it. So the computer outputs can be categorized into two types: soft copy output and hard copy output. So what is the basic difference, or when we say a soft copy output, which is displayed on the monitor or on the screen, we cannot touch it or we cannot feel it. So that is what we call it as the soft copy. So we can view that information, or like for example the same screen. So the information is available, you can all watch this sentences and other things, but we cannot touch it with our, I mean, we cannot see it properly. I mean, we cannot use this information and send this to somebody else in a hard copy. And we call them as the temporary in nature, because for time being it is visible. So once I finish with this video, and once I finish with close this PowerPoint presentation, you cannot use it. But whereas when we are having a hard copy or a printout, or when you take a Xerox, it will be permanent. You can use it, the same duplicate copies you can take, and you can send it to your friends, or if you want to send it a letter, and the other things that you can usually do with that. So the computer outputs are categorized into soft copy and hard copy outputs. So the information that is displayed on the screen or on the monitor, that we call it as the soft copy output. And the information that is available in terms of papers, or when we take some banners, print out of banners and other things, so that can be called as the hard copy, which is we can touch it and we can feel it. And let us discuss about the monitors. So monitors are the most widely used output devices, because whenever we are interacting with the computer, the basic element that is required is the monitor. With that, we also have the keyboard, so that we can properly interact with the computer and we can get the information. So monitors can be categorized, or two types of monitors that we have, that is the CRT monitors and the LCD. So the, as you can see, this we rarely use these types of monitors these days, but in the earlier days, if you compare in last 10 years, we are not using them. But they are similar to like our television screen, and the information will be displayed on the this screen. So the basic working of this CRT monitors remain same. We call them as CRT monitors because they have this element called as cathode ray tube. Because of this, we have this CRT monitor. Then what are the parts that are present on this monitor, I mean in this CRT cathode ray tube? So it basically consists of this is the fluorescent screen from which from this side we can view the information, and it consists of anode, control grid, okay, and cathode, electron beam. All those things are present in this, inside the cathode ray tube. So we are not going to study in detail about how this works and working mechanism and other things, but just we need to understand the importance of having this CRT monitor. So it basically produces the information on the monitor screen, or we can call this as the soft copy output device, because the whatever the information that is visible on the screen, we cannot take any printout of it. I mean, if you are connected with the printer, we can take it, but the information that is displayed now, you can read all this information. So this is the soft copy output we can see. The drawback of having this is they consume more electricity than the LCD, and they require more space compared to the LCD screens. So in the earlier days, if you see, when we are using this television system or these type of monitors, they consume lot of energy or electricity. So because of that, we don't prefer to use them, and they consist of this color tube. And if that is damaged, then almost we need to replace the entire monitor itself. So we don't prefer them. So then one more category of monitors that we have is the LCD, that is liquid crystal display. Again, as the name it suggests, the material that is being used here is the liquid crystal. So it uses liquid crystal to display the images, and it requires less space and power. So compared to the LCD, compared to the CRT monitors, the space required to place this LCD monitors is very less, and also their power consumption also very less. And they are portable because of their lightweight, and they are not heavy compared to the CRT monitors. And we can easily place them from one place to another place. It is easily possible to change this position and other things. So we call them as the flat panel. I mean, the screen of these monitors will be very thin and widely used in these present days. We can say that the LCD monitors are thinner, lighter, and they consume very less power compared to the CRT monitors. Monitors are also called as the visual display unit. Basically, whenever we are using these monitors, we connect the keyboard and at the terminals. So because they produce the visual images, or they produce the information on the screen visually, it is available. So we call them as the visual display unit. It forms images from tiny dots called as pixels. So how the actual images are produced on the screen or on the monitor is based on the concept of pixels. So whenever we have some images on the screen, so those images are made up of small pixels, or we can say tiny dots. We call them as the pixels that are arranged in the rectangular form. So this is just an example of pixels, how they are formed. So when you see some images, each image consists of a small tiny rectangular boxes, we can say, and we can mark each of these rectangle with their positions, like x-axis and y-axis, with rows and columns. So these small grids together makes the pixels, and like collection of these pixels will give the entire image. Or we can say that a pixel is the smallest unit or a smallest entity of a image. Now let's discuss about the hard copy output devices. Hard copy output devices are like printers. So printers can be categorized based on their working mechanism: impact printers and non-impact printers. And again, in impact printer we have dot matrix and daisy wheel. And in non-impact printer, we can have inkjet printers, laser printers, thermal printers, and so on. So based on their working mechanism, we categorize printers into impact printers and non-impact printers. So now let us understand in brief about these printers. So what is the meaning of this impact printers? So when we say printers, it requires some ribbon, it requires ink to produce the printouts, and so on. So the impact printers, like, there is a direct contact between the ink ribbon and the paper. So we have different types of printers, like dot matrix and daisy wheel, and so on. So it has got mechanical movement of these different parts, and the paper will come in contact with this ink ribbon, and then we get the outputs. So the output can be again numbers, digits, alphabets, and so on, or alphanumeric characters. So all these will be produced by keeping the paper in contact with this ink ribbon. So we call them as the impact. So there is a impact of or there is a connection, or there is a contact of paper with the ink ribbon. So we call them as the impact printers, and they have mechanical moving parts to conduct printing. So to take the printout or to get the output, we need to these mechanical parts will be rotated, or they will move from one place to another place, and so on. So these printers are noisy but yet popular, but they make a lot of sound. When we suppose assume that when we are taking a printout of 100 pages or 1000 pages, if you use these impact printers, it takes not only time but also it produces lot of noise, but yet they are popular. So these days we don't prefer using them, but still because of their popularity and they are cheap in the market, so they are easily available, so we use them to take a large copy of prints. So printers can be of dot matrix printers, impact printers can be categorized again as dot matrix and DC fill. So let us understand these two now. So these are character printers that print one character at a time. So again, we can have line printers as well, where the printers will print one line at a time, but we call them as the dot matrix. And these are the character printers, so they will print character by character, one character at a time. So when there is a contact of or mechanical movement in the printers, they will print one character at a time. So character printers that form characters and all kinds of images as a pattern of dots. So whether you are printing the characters or images, everything will be printed in terms of small tiny dots or characters, we can say. And their capability is very less, and they range from 330 to 600 characters per second. So this is their capability. So this is the example of the character printer, or in fact the dot matrix printers. So as you can see here, in the banking industry or in LIC and wherever we have or we need to take lot of printouts, or even if you go for electricity bill generation, so in the earlier days they were using these dot matrix printers, and there will be a paper will be placed on this, and then there will be a ribbon present here, carbon ribbon, and there will be a mechanical movement of this ribbon with the paper. So when the ribbon comes in contact with this paper, character by character the alphabets will be printed on the paper. So as you can see here, just an example. So if you want to take a printout of this, and if information is like hello, so how this is how it appears on the dot matrix. So all these characters like H A L L O, all these are based on small tiny dots, or in one particular alphabet we can see lot of dots or tiny spots we can see. So like this, the characters or images will be printed on this. So we don't prefer to use dot matrix printers when we want to take the images, because the images will come in this particular format, and we don't like to take printouts of images like in this form. So basically when we are having invoice bill generation, or when we have a lot of printouts to be taken, and when we have a lot of time, that time we can prefer using them, because they consume more electricity, and as well as their speed is very less compared to the laser printers or the latest inkjet printers. Because they fall under the category of impact printers, because there is a contact of paper with the ribbon, so lot of noise will be produced. So that is one drawback of having this dot matrix printers. It basically consists of a print head which will activate the pins present on each characters, and the moment it horizontally moves from one place to another place, so a character by character will be printed on this. So once the entire line is finished, again the paper has to be placed, and again it is like a movement of cursor. So again it will start with the left side, and again the characters by characters will be printed, and again we need to move the position of this paper. For faster printing, many dot matrix printers print both the ways, that is from left to right and also from right to left. So we can also call them as the bi-directional printers. Next we have is the DC fill printers. So as the name suggests, let us look into the diagram of daisy wheel printer. So as you can see here, it consists of a wheel like architecture, and it consists of a motor which rotates continuously, and the characters are embossed on these pins, we can see. So this printer has a wheel on which characters are embossed. So in a broader view, if you observe, these are the characters that are present on this wheel, and it consists of a hammer, and then this we call as the print head, which will rotate in the circular fashion or in a 360 degree. So as this wheel rotates, the characters that are present on this particular pins that will come in contact with this ribbon. This is the black color is the ribbon, and then we have this paper. So as there is a connection of this with the hammer strikes with this ribbon. The moment it strikes the ribbon, the whatever character is present on this particular pins will be printed on this printers. I mean, will be printed on this paper. To tell about the characters of daisy wheel printers, they are slow, having printing speeds in the range of 25 to 50 characters per second. So they are very, very slow. And when printing, the printer rotates the disk to each character, and using a hammer strikes each character into an ink ribbon to create characters on paper. As we discussed, so the print head will be continuously rotating to strike with this, and will be this hammer will strike this, and we can get the outputs, or we can get the hard copy output, we can say. Again, the drawback of daisy wheel printer also remains same, because they are having this mechanical movement. Many things are involved in this, rotating motor is required and other things, so they are noisy in nature. So in these days we don't prefer to use them, and their speed is also very, very slow. But in the olden days we used these printers for small printouts and other things. So next we have is the chain printers. The print element in a chain printer is a metallic band or chain containing the embossed characters that rotates horizontally in front of paper. So let us understand the working of chain printers. As you can see here, just compared to a chain of a bicycle or any vehicle, you can say. So this is the ribbon and this is the chain, and here we have this back of paper. And again, if you observe this, this also belongs to the category of impact printer, because there is a contact of these mechanical devices, the paper, the ribbon and this entire chain, and this will be the print hammer. So on this chain the characters are embossed, or the characters are present on this chain. As you can see here, these are the characters like X, W, V, U, all this. So as this chain continuously rotates, and when this character comes in contact with the ribbon, so whatever the character is contacting with this ribbon, that will be produced on the paper. So it requires the print hammer first. So the when the print hammer strikes this paper, it will come in contact with this ribbon, and then this chain is continuously rotating in the horizontal fashion, and the characters that are present on this chain will come in contact with the ribbon, and the same characters will be placed or produced on the paper. So compared to the daisy wheel or dot matrix printer, they are popularly used, or they were used in the earlier days, and their capacity or the speed was 400 to 2500 characters per second. The speed of that, when we compare in terms of lines, they can range from 400 to 3000 lines per minute. So these are the some characteristics of chain printers. So these are the some of the important impact printers that we have discussed. So only thing you need to remember is the types of impact printers and their one or two characteristics, and their speed and their capability of printing the characters, or how many lines they can print per minute or per second, and so on. So in detailed discussion we have in the third unit. In that time we'll be discussing about in detail about their working mechanism and other things. Thank you all.